When I was in high school, I decided one day that since I like video games so much, why don't I try making some? After a quick Google search, I found Game Maker 7 and loved it. However, I quickly learned how to code and felt that I've outgrown the engine. I then moved on to Adobe Flash, and when that faded into obscurity, I then picked up Unity. After fighting a painful visual bug with my 2D game, I decided that Unity was not for me. I ported my game over to Corona SDK, which is now Solar 2D, but found that the lack of a user interface made it time-consuming to use. At this point, I really didn't have a game engine that I could call home. Even Game Maker itself didn't feel right anymore with newer releases. Combine this with getting a full-time job, gamedev fell to the wayside for a while. When the pandemic hit in 2020, I found myself permanently working from home with more downtime, and it was then I discovered Godot. It did not take long for Godot to click with me, given its node and scene system and a straight-to-the-point scripting language. It was simple, intuitive, and had very little fluff. Godot played a big part in rekindling my love for game dev, and I have it to thank for that. I believe Godot has a real shot at becoming a mainstream game engine, and there's many reasons why. Let me take some time to tell you why I believe in Godot, and why I'll be waiting for Godot's inevitable success. First and foremost, one of my favorite things about Godot is the design around how scenes and nodes work. If you're unfamiliar, nodes in Godot are units of functionality, such as a physics body, a sprite, or a timer. Scenes are a collection of nodes organized in a hierarchy. You can build any number of scenes and design them in such a way that they effectively become their own objects in your game. Think of scenes like Unity's prefab system, if you're familiar with that, but designed from the ground up. This structure is valuable for making games because you can build logical components in your game through composition. For example, your player character may contain a sprite, some hitboxes, and even a UI. You can also use the node system to build a finite state machine if you would rather not have hundreds of lines of code in your player script. I believe the node system is flexible and scalable, and once larger projects are built with Godot, other devs will likely feel the same way. To complement this solid foundation, Godot has GDScript, which I believe is a quick and fun to use language. GDScript is a Python-like language specific to the Godot game engine. While it isn't as robust as, say, JavaScript or even Python, it keeps improving and I still think it's pretty efficient for implementing things quickly. In Godot 4, GDScript now supports lambdas, which are inline functions. It also brought in utility array functions, like map and reduce, which are great for quickly manipulating data. There are technical reasons why the Godot dev team did not use Python instead, but GDScript is close enough to it that it's easy to pick up. I know the loose typing nature of the language can be a turnoff for some developers, but GDScript offers ways to mitigate that, such as optional static typing. However, the value of being able to stand up some game logic like basic platformer movement in just a few lines of code cannot be understated. If GDScript doesn't convince you, Godot has great C# support, and there's a growing pool of community-maintained support for other languages. If the scripting options weren't enough, Godot supports being extended in many ways, such as addons, GD extension, or just straight up modifying the source code. Unfortunately, I don't know much about GD extension or the source code at this time, so I'll focus on addons. Addons are sweet because they're easy to install and use in your projects. All you need to do is find the relevant addon on GitHub, download the zip file, and then extract it into an addons folder in your project. There's also some addons you can get through the asset library in the engine directly. This helps a ton to patch up some missing features in the engine, like this Jigglebone addon that works great for the secondary animation on my character here. Having an add-on system like this is useful in keeping Godot lightweight, so it can run on as many PCs as possible. Of course, this means that other developers will have to create and maintain these add-ons, so the quality will vary. You may be surprised to see how effective some of them can be, though. The extensibility of Godot isn't the only thing that's comprehensive. The documentation is, too. I think the quality of the documentation tends to get overlooked a bit, but I honestly have found it to be a godsend when working on my games. Just the other day, I found a really comprehensive article on GDScript style conventions. Not only did it answer my questions about how I could organize my code, it explained the rationale for every best practice there. To go even further, accessing the documentation while working on your code is extremely easy. Just hold the control key and select a function in your code to open the docs. And with Nathan from GDQuest now working on the documentation, it's only going to get better in the future. Most importantly, though, what ties all these great things together is the community behind the Godot engine. I relied on the community quite a bit when I was just starting this YouTube channel up again. Y'all gave me great suggestions for videos that I plan to cover in the future. Plus, you gave me a bunch of support by subscribing to my channel. Not only that, but this community loves to support other Godot developers and games, and it's great seeing how much love other games are getting. From what I've seen as well, the average Godot developer is more of a fan of the engine than other engine users are of their respective engines. I think it's nice that people really enjoy using the tool they chose to make games and aren't just using it to get the job done. People really want Godot to succeed, and it shows. While there's so much about Godot that's great, I think it's only fair to offer some things that Godot could still work on. For example, some workflows in the engine feel a bit cumbersome or unintuitive. I like organizing UI via nodes, and it's really easy to create and reference UI elements, but I find a container system to be aggravating sometimes. Moving UI elements just slightly within the child of a container requires another container, and it becomes a sea of nested container nodes. While I appreciate the effort that Godot 4 has made to clarify the container node functions, I feel like reworking a container nodes to work more like CSS used for web development would make the most sense. I also believe that the Godot dev team should build and maintain official add-ons. I appreciate that anyone can make add-ons, but officially supported add-ons can go a long way in building trust with the users of the engine. With a lot of developers coming from Unity, making official terrain or jigglebone add-ons, to name a few, could be a great opportunity. After all, no engine is perfect. It's great though that Godot is free and open source, so it means that there's a great chance these things will become part of the engine in the future. So where does my channel fit into all this? I'll admit, I'm no AAA game developer, and I don't have professional game developer experience. However, I am a professional software engineer with over 10 years of experience, and I've been in the game dev hobby for a long time. Since my two games are fairly large projects, I believe I'll be running into a lot of real-world scenarios that I'll need to figure out how to implement, using the help of the community as well as my own problem-solving skills. This includes things such as making 3D cutscenes, managing many attack animations, efficient workflows for making 3D models and importing them into Godot, and more. I also will focus on not only how to solve the problem, but why the solutions I choose make sense. There are a lot of beginner-friendly tutorials for getting started with Godot, but I feel there's a lack of tutorials that focus on real-world scenarios and how to tackle them within the context of Godot. Not all of us will have the experience of working for a game studio, so this type of exposure would be fantastic. What do you think of Godot? Are you as optimistic as I am about the engine? Did you switch over from another game engine, or is Godot your first one? Let me know in the comments. Otherwise, thank you and I hope you have a great day.